You are watching The Story. Every Monday, we bring you a deep dive into the fascinating lives of incredible people. How the founder of FedEx saved the company from bankruptcy with his blackjack winnings. Welcome to Alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. If you're not subscribed yet, you're missing out. Hello, Aluxers, and welcome back. Does the name Frederick Smith sound familiar to you? Maybe, maybe not, but you've definitely heard of his multi-billion dollar company, FedEx. Founded as Federal Express in 1973, FedEx fundamentally changed the way people and businesses ship and receive packages. In 2018, FedEx had over $65 billion worth of revenue, but business has not always been booming. Today, we're going to look at the incredible story of how Frederick Smith saved FedEx from bankruptcy with his blackjack winnings. But first, who is Frederick Smith? Frederick Smith is most notably the founder, chairman, and CEO of the American multinational delivery services company, FedEx. He had his share of struggles as a child, with his father dying when he was only 4 and then contracting a crippling bone disease. Later in life, he went to Yale, graduated with an economics degree, and then joined the Marines. After serving 2 tours of duty in Vietnam, he received the Silver Star, the Bronze Star, and 2 Purple Hearts. At the age of 26, he bought the controlling interest in Arc Aviation Sales, which was an aircraft maintenance company. He then shifted the focus of the company to trading used jets. That same year, Smith founded Federal Express and achieved his longtime dream of owning a package delivery company. Today, Frederick Smith's net worth is about $3.7 billion. In addition to his stake in FedEx, he's also the co-owner of the Washington Redskins NFL team and several entertainment and production companies. But today, we're focusing on FedEx, so let's go back to the start. Beginnings. While he was a student at Yale, Smith wrote a paper describing his idea for a shipping company that specializes in time-sensitive shipments. His idea was revolutionary for the shipping industry at the time, but he only got a C grade on the paper. Still, the idea never left him. Even when he was serving in Vietnam, he paid close attention to how supply deliveries were handled. In 1971, when he was 27 years old, he received a $4 million inheritance, which is worth about $25 million at today's valuation. He used the money to found his dream company, Federal Express. What's more, he was quickly able to raise $91 million in venture capital, which is close to $573 million by today's standards. The vision. Smith's vision was very basic but radical at the same time. He wanted to provide an easy way for companies and individuals to have packages delivered in 1 to 2 days. At this point in time, package delivery was handled by air freight shippers who didn't provide urgent shipments. Smith's idea did more than change an industry. It created a new industry altogether. Smith had a clear vision for this, but there were plenty of speed bumps along the way. The struggle. On April 17, 1973, Federal Express officially launched operations in Memphis, Tennessee. That night, a total of 14 small aircraft delivered 186 packages to 25 cities throughout the United States. It was an exciting time, but all the investments dwindled rapidly with expenses increasing as fuel prices continued to rise. At one point, the company was losing $1 million a month. Some pilots were asked to use their personal credit cards to pay for fuel with a promise of reimbursement. Other times, paychecks were distributed, but employees were asked not to cash them. Everything was seemingly crashing down around Frederick Smith. He'd invested his last penny in his dream company, and he had numerous other investors counting on this concept to work well. The company was on the brink of bankruptcy with only $5,000 in the bank. It seemed Smith had one last chance to save the company. He was scheduled to give a pitch to the board of General Dynamics, a global aerospace and defense company, in order to secure a company-saving loan. When they turned down his loan request, it seemed the company was doomed, but one desperate act changed everything. The win. Smith was waiting at the airport in Chicago for his flight back to Memphis. His pitch to General Dynamics had failed, and he knew there wasn't even enough money left in the bank to pay for fuel for the planes for the next week. Smith then made an impulsive decision that would change the trajectory of his company and his life. He canceled his flight to Memphis and jumped on a flight to Las Vegas. Smith spent the weekend at the high-stakes blackjack table, gambling with the company's last $5,000. Many hands later, he turned that $5,000 into $27,000. When the money mysteriously appeared in the company account, allowing them to pay their fuel bill, Roger Frock, the senior vice president of operations, asked Smith where it came from. He was shocked to find out that Frederick had gambled with the company's last dime. What difference does it make? Without the funds for the fuel companies, we couldn't have flown anyway. The amount Smith won was just enough to keep the company afloat, but the win also gave Smith the motivation to secure more funding. He went on to raise between $50 and $70 million from a total of 20 risk venture speculators. Federal Express became the most highly financed new company in the history of the US up to that point. The company finally began turning a profit in 1976, with an average delivery of 19,000 parcels per day. Build up. Federal Express grew rapidly and was servicing over 100 American cities by 1980. During the 80s, Federal Express experienced 40% compounded growth annually. In 1983, sales topped $1 billion for the first time. It was the first company in U.S. history to achieve this milestone within the first 10 years of launching, without mergers and acquisitions involved. Federal Express had single-handedly established the express shipping industry and continually set the standard for their competitors. They also became the first shipping company to utilize a computer to manage packages in 1979. In 1984, they launched international service. They also introduced package tracking technology in 1986. In 1994, the company designated the name FedEx as its official brand. Today, FedEx has a market cap of $41.5 billion. It serves 220 countries worldwide, with an average of 14 million packages shipped daily. Now in his mid-70s, Frederick Smith continues his role as CEO to drive the company to remain competitive and relevant. The lesson. There are a few different lessons that can be learned from this fascinating story. For one, incredible risk can result in incredible rewards, but this story could have had another ending altogether. If Smith had lost the blackjack table that night, we almost certainly wouldn't be talking about FedEx right now. But Smith knew the risks and decided to take bold action with everything on the line. Sometimes this is necessary. Success is not guaranteed through such actions, but without them, failure is almost inevitable. One book that could help you avoid some of the common pitfalls when growing a new business is Startup CEO, a field guide to scaling up your business. In this book, Michael Bloomberg gives keen insights and practical advice about the challenges a startup CEO might face in the critical development years. You can listen to this helpful book on Audible while also saving $25. Just go to Alux.com/freebook and sign up. If it's your first time, you'll get the audiobook version for free, thanks to our partnership with Audible. The quote. While researching his story, we came across this simple but inspiring quote from Frederick that goes like this. Never let fear be the reason you don't try something. Frederick has also said he's not afraid to take a swing and miss. Fear of failure is what holds so many people back from fulfilling their dreams. Don't allow yourself to become one of those people. Question. Now that we're wrapping up this incredible story, we'd like to know, which casino game would you try your luck at if you knew your company was on the line? Let us know in the comments. And of course, for sticking with us until the end, here's your bonus. FedEx maintains the world's largest cargo air fleet with a total of more than 650 planes. On any given night, FedEx flies five or more empty planes across the US so they can respond quickly to any change in cargo demand or take over for any plane that's grounded due to mechanical problems. Thank you for spending some time with us, Aluxers. Make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpicked these videos, which we recommend you watch next. You can talk to us on all social medias or ask a question on our website, Alux.com. Thank you for being an Aluxer, and we'll see you back tomorrow.